I don't know if any of you guys watched my 100 songs I love for 100K video, but I used the clip from Makeup Drawer and it was, yeah. I like your makeup for love, where do you get your foundation? Ooh la la la, it's so, so pretty, yeah. Hey beans, what is up? How you guys doing? I hope you're doing well. Tonight, we are here with Isaac Dunbar. Yes, there he is. King, love you. He came out with a new EP that I didn't know this was happening. I just found out today when it came out, or it might have come out yesterday, I don't know. But the EP is called Evil Twin, and I checked out his Instagram, and what he said about it is actually pretty cool. So he posted this picture of the album cover. It says, my EP Evil Twin is out. Evil Twin is a display of my current state of mind in regards to my artistry and ego. A part of me wants to make the experimental music I love to listen to, and the other half of me loves the pop music. So I had my Evil Twin sing the experimental records, and I sang the pop records. That is such a cool concept. If I had to tell you guys my favorite Isaac songs, I think I would go with Makeup Drawer, Isaac's Insects. Suicide and Colony are so depressing, but I adore both of those tracks. And then on Balloons Don't Float Here, I love Ferrari and Cologne. Oh, I'm so interested to see what he does here. And I'm interested to see if I'm able to pick up on what like the two sounds are gonna be, because again, it's like him versus his evil twin. Oh my God, I love that concept. We're gonna start out, guys, with track one, Pink Party. Oh, this is the evil twin all day. Where are we going? When he said evil twin, like he meant Satan. Okay, experimental, yeah, yeah, a little bit. I wasn't ready for this. Oh my God, that just scared the living hell out of me. Terrifying. Oh my God, who is it? Who, the evil twin is so scary. You wanna talk about shock value. That was, wow. I mean, like, I wasn't able to even focus on it because I was so shocked. Like, I knew, okay, yeah, he was gonna make something experimental, but I was not prepared for what just happened. Wait, I kind of want to listen to it again already. Like, that is so not my style of music at all. Like, I've never listened to anything like it, but I kind of already want to play it again. Okay, wait, this is weird. I'm wondering if he's gonna alternate or if it's gonna be half and half or it's gonna be random. I don't know, but the next song is called Fan Behavior.
I guess I've got myself a fan.
Wait, I really like this sound. I can't wait to learn the lyrics to this and sing along. Like, I already want to. I don't know the words, but I'm like, oh wait, this is so fun. This is so cool because, like, I don't even know if this is pop or if this is the experimental sound, because it could totally fit into both. It's such a unique song. What is this feeling? I just feel like strobe light, right? This is so unique. That, like, is, like, I don't hear song, like, that is so unique. Oh my God, I'm freaking out. Okay, again with this song, I just wanna listen to it again right now. Wait, I really like that one too. Two for two, two for two. The first one, again, scary, but I still liked it. The next track we're gonna listen to is Rendezvous. This is already so good. Like, this whole, this project. Confess. Oh, his melodies are so good. Usually I fall for you, but now I'm sent out.
so quick to resign. I'm tired of the one foot inside shit.
I feel like this song can't be loud enough. Like, I want it to be louder. Oh, he's got such a voice. I just don't know, like, I don't know what I was expecting from this EP, but, like, he's surprised me so much in the best way. Like, this has just been so unique and different, and just, you can tell there's such a creative process behind these songs so far. I love this concept. Oh my god, everything about this is so cool. Okay, where are we going now? Next is Intimate Moments. I like that title a lot.
I need to get this off my chest.
Oh, I already like it.
I'm getting it for once and more. So I'll wait for the perfect time. I have a fear of intimate moments. If you're around, why am I down? My walls and try.
I can't believe this song right now. Oh my god, I don't know if I want to like get into this right now. I've been making some serious self-discoveries in the past couple weeks, and this song just hit on the biggest one. And I can't, I'm sitting here in shock. I've discovered something about myself that this song is directly addressing, and I was literally trying to write a song about it. And now he just presents me with this.
So I'll wait for the perfect time. Yeah, I'll wait for the perfect time. And I might cry with some moments. If you're around, why am I down? I can't open up. You don't have to stay in life. If I can't.
Wow, 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 wow. That might be my favorite just for like the lyrics. He hit so close for me with that song. And I love the sound of it too. It was like more of like obviously a slower sound, a slow song, but still had that strength in it because it was still like, oh, I don't know. There was still a lot of depth to it, but it was slower and more emotional and the lyrics were great. And there was that like note near the end that he was like, oh, his voice. Oh, I love this. Oh my god, thank you for this song, Isaac. The next song is Love or the Lack Thereof. He's got really good titles. I remember that from his other projects too, like Isaac's Insects and Balloons Don't Float Here. Like, those also have really cool titles. Is this gonna make me cry too?
Hopes of your love. Not my fault that I crave your attention.
Oh no.
My fault.
Oh. This has main character energy, as Anthony Aiken Jr. would say. We're in an indie film. This is an indie film. Holy shit. Okay, wait, these last two have been my two favorites. Oh, lyrically, again, the lyrics. Now I'm thinking maybe the first few were the Evil Twin songs because those were like the kind of chaotic sounds and lyrics, like the lyrics being a little bit less sensical. Not that they don't have meaning, that it's just my brain's too small to get it. The last two have been like, I grasped them and like understood them and felt them immediately. And that's like really important for me in music, is like all about the lyrics and how I connect to them. So these last two songs have been it for me. And the sound of that one was so fun, definitely poppy. Oh, I loved it. This is such a cool project. I love it. Okay, okay. Where are we going, Isaac?
Nice to meet you, I'm pleased, cause I've seen you around.
That. The Forever Part. Oh, Teenage Dream on repeat! Oh my god, I love it. This song gives me a little bit of a Bleachers vibe. I don't know if you guys can see the album cover, where it is up there, so you guys can't see it. But, you know, these little like speaking pieces remind me a little bit of how Bleachers songs sound, and Bleachers is one of my favorite bands ever. Like, they're so good. Jack Antonoff, love him. Anyway, alright, this is definitely another pop one, and I love it.
Today and tomorrow. Kiss, kiss, kiss,
kiss. And then that click at the end, like almost like the projection. I don't know if that's what that was, but it, like, that's what I thought of. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I love it. So we've made it to the last song. This is The World and All Her Pearls. Again, really cool title. I don't know if we're gonna end with the pop sound or the Evil Twin sound.
Why can't I cry?
Oh no. Are you gonna hurt me at the end of the album, like you did with Isaac's Insects? Because the end of Isaac's Insects with Suicide and Colony back to back is just so painful. Now we're gonna end with, this sounds horrifically incredible. Oh, before we keep going, I like that he's getting a chance to showcase his vocals in this song, because in some of the other songs, obviously the production really takes over. Like, a lot of his music is really strong on production, but in this one, he's getting a chance to showcase his vocals, and he has really, really beautiful vocals, so I love that for this. Get lost in them. Do you feel like the atmosphere that's built? It's either space or like we're in the well or some kind of magical looking garden, but it's dark. Oh my god, that he likes to end on a sad note, because that was really heavy, but in a really beautiful way. That created a whole world, a whole atmosphere that I just wanted to be engulfed by. I just felt like I could like reach into the song and like just, I don't know what I would pull out, but it's like, I don't know how to explain it. And again, I love that like you really heard his voice on that song. Wow, what a cool project. I think the first three, Pink Party, Fan Behavior, and Rendezvous, were supposed to be more of the like experimental songs, and then the last four were more of the pop ones, but I could be wrong, that's just my guess. If I had to pick favorites, I feel like it'd be Fan Behavior, Intimate Moments, Love or the Lack Thereof, and The World and All Her Pearls. I liked the other ones as well, but I think those were probably the ones that stood out the most to me. Guys, this is incredible. Go stream Isaac's music. Give him all the love and support. Like, stream all three of his projects, because all three of them are really, really incredible projects. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, for watching this video, for listening to Isaac with me. I've absolutely loved this really unique project. So, so cool. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to like, subscribe down below. If you're interested, only if you want to, no pressure whatsoever. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.